and she performed with us for the 100th anniversary of Norwegian independence in May of 2005. Everyone fell in love with her, and we invited her then, and she was able to work us into her schedule. So we're honored and delighted to have Sissel from Norway joining us this Christmas season.
And she is also joining us on the line right now. Sissel, what a great, great pleasure to have you with us here on KSL and anticipating your visit to Salt Lake City. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much. It's my honor.
we were all kind of wondering if we dare actually try to pronounce your last name. You may have heard a little of the speculation here. We decided to let you do that.
Yeah, it's a little bit difficult. It's Kjetil.
That's why we decided to let you say it.
That's why we let you say it. Now, we can handle Sissel, and we are just delighted. Craig, you have introduced us over these many years to so many wonderful artists, and we are just so looking forward to this.
Well, I think, like when we brought Bryn Terfel, many were not familiar with Bryn, and Sissel has actually worked with Bryn before and knows him well, and Audra McDonald. Sissel will create as big a stir as anyone we've ever brought before. She already has. And Sissel, we're so honored you're going to come. Thanks for joining us this morning as well.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You know, it's not morning here where I am. It's in the evening, so it's
That's
not
right.
too bad.
Have you ever been to Utah before when you've performed with the Tabernacle Choir before? Was that right here in Utah?
Yes, that was, I think, was it the conference? I remember the temple was still under on work, and I remember it was my first time ever in Utah. I've heard so much about it. I have friends who've been skiing and to come over there and to feel this warmth, and people were so, we met so much love when we came to Salt Lake City, so I can't wait to come back.
Oh, that is exciting. We're looking forward to having you here. So this event celebrating that anniversary you were referring to, Craig, happened here then?
It did. May 2005, and we dedicated the entire Music and the Spoken Word broadcast to Norway. And there's a very large Scandinavian community in the Salt Lake Valley.
That's right.
Representing all the countries, but the Norwegians were particularly proud and in great force that morning. And they're ecstatic, Sissel, that you're coming again. We all are.
I'm too.
one thing, Doug, I'm going to mention, one of the great Norwegian traditions at Christmas time, Scandinavian, is Santa Lucia procession. Sissel, will you tell our listeners about the Santa Lucia tradition in Scandinavia?
Well, what we actually do is that some cities, especially in Sweden, they have, like, every city has their own Santa Lucia choir. And this is girls and boys who has a kind of parade in the streets or at hospitals, and they wear like white dresses or white uniforms, and they sing this beautiful song Santa Lucia, and they make special cakes, Santa Lucia kata. And for instance, all the my daughters, when they went to kindergarten, they had like choirs. They start 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock in the morning, and then they visit different hospitals, and then some of them, and then they might sing for some older girls as well, kids as well. And it's a huge tradition, and the kids, they just love it because they get this, you know, they really become like a little angel, and I got this, oh. And they look so gorgeous. They look wonderful.
And what do they wear on their heads?
Well, they wear like a crown of lights. The first that like the Santa Lucia girl or the princess, or I don't know how you translate it into English, but she has like this crown of lights, of candles, that when she walks in the front of the parade, and it looks so wonderful. And all the others, they have the candles in their hands. So it's very beautiful when you hear these children's voices coming, singing Santa Lucia.
You ought to see the smile on Craig's face right now. What have you got in store for us here?
Well, Sissel's not aware of this, but in honor of her visit and celebrating this tradition, we're going to create our own Santa Lucia procession with a children's choir and lights. And it's going to be not only beautiful to hear, but it's going to be really very moving to look at. I think, Sissel, you'll feel like you're back home for just a moment.
Well, I know I will.
That is so exciting. You know, you're describing a Scandinavian Norwegian Christmas. I used to work for a little grocery store that was operated by a family by the name of Nygren that came from the Scandinavian countries and from Norway. And every year, people would come in from all over the Intermountain West for the lutefisk and the limpa bread and the reindeer meatball, the Gouda cheese. And I'll tell you, I had a real education. And boy, talk about an interesting array of aromas and flavors. And it's one of my fondest memories of Christmas time.
My we lived in Europe for 4 years, and one of our fondest memories is a family vacation to Norway. And this was in July, and we went fishing at midnight, and it still was light outside.
Yeah.
But I know in the winter, it gets dark very, very early. And sometimes I think during the deepest part of winter, it's dark almost the entire day. But the lighting of candles becomes very important, as I remember, in those countries to bring light to that dark part of the year.
We are just honored and so excited to have you come and visit us here and share your great talents with us at Christmas time. And Craig, you brought along a CD. Could we actually hear a little bit?
I did. Sissel, I want to play Vitae Lux for them.
Oh.
Can you tell them the translation of this?
It's the light of life, and it's a Norwegian song actually, and it describes this importance of keeping the light of life, keep it glowing and believing in it, and always keep it in your heart.
Get ready to hear this voice of an angel.
Okay,
Sissel,
here we go.
Oh,
Greg, you said we'd hear the voice of an angel, and we truly did. That was just
Isn't she beautiful? And she is equally beautiful to look at. She's just
just gorgeous. As a matter of fact, we were just talking. Boy, that ethereal sound in the beginning is so beautiful. And I understand that your voice was, people who may not be totally familiar, you provided voice in the movie Titanic, is that correct?
Yes, I was, there is a voice going through the whole movie, and yeah, that's me.
That's you. Well, once again, we are just honored to have you on the line with us now. We are so looking forward to having you visit Salt Lake City again and participate in this amazing celebration that we all love and look forward to each and every year in the Conference Center with the Tabernacle Choir. And I can't thank you enough for sharing this time and sharing your gifts with us here in Utah. We are so excited to have you here.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Craig.